Copenhagen Wolves versus the Super Hot Crew. First thing I want to ask you is, how serious did you take this game? Obviously, we saw Mixa taking the record there for most deaths, but I do assume that you want to get some wins under your belt going into playoffs.
Yeah, the thing is that we still have an option to move up in the ladder, so we obviously want to win, maybe get a better matchup in the playoffs. So we actually took it quite serious, but after the early game, which went kind of weirdly, we got an advantage at some point after we took some drakes, took some turrets. They didn't take it that serious anymore, and we just wanted to get kills as well.
And how important is it actually for you guys to get the fifth place? Is there any team you really want to face in this playoff?
I really want to face Rocket, to be honest. I don't know how possible that is, but I think we match them pretty well. And we have been beating them in this challenge scene and in the LCS as well. Like, we're 2-2, but we had a really dumb loss versus them. And I think we match up really well.
And then, again, playoff, of course. What do you actually think your chances are if you come into the playoffs here? Because most people, when they look at the standings, are going to say, you guys are going to be one of the underdogs coming in. Of course, we have all the big teams in the playoffs now. How well do you think you guys can perform? Can you actually take it all the way?
Well, we have really high potential, in my opinion. In some games, we show it. In some other, we don't. So we could make it a dream story, basically, like getting to the finals or something like that. I think GGU had a similar run back then or something like that, and we may repeat it.
Can I follow up on the Fischio's earlier question, who you want to face, who do you absolutely not want to face? Who is the strongest team in Europe for you right now?
Oh, that's a tough question. I think that SK is really strong. Obviously, we won't face them first round. It's impossible, they're first. But in general, like maybe Fnatic or strong Gambit.
And I asked Youngborg about this last week. I actually want to talk with you now about it. The challenger scene, you have so much experience from it. When you look at the current challenger teams, how strong do you think they are compared to when you guys actually qualified?
Well, I think right now the LCS is its strongest point. Aside from NIP being out, maybe Exchange in SHG or Millennium, the LCS has never been stronger. And that means our level of play is way higher compared to the challenger teams. And I think we would, even if we get relegated, not drop out of LCS.
All right, so a lot of confidence there. Congratulations for you. Thank you for talking to us. We also asked you guys at home again to answer us on Twitter. And today we asked you, which European LCS team have you had the most fun watching this split and why? And here are some of your answers. The first one is from @whoa_that_play. Fnatic, the midseason was harsh, but it made the way they are playing now that much more fun to watch.
I have to agree. I mean, when the season started, they went 7-0. Everyone was like, Fnatic, best team we got in Europe. And they just continued to dominate here. It was nice to follow them. Then when they actually started losing, you were just waiting for them to get the comeback, to get to the point where they started winning again. And now seeing them bounce back here and have the chance to claim the second spot in the league, it's a beautiful story.
All planned.
All planned.
The second one is from @paperplaneslol. Rocket, their champion and team comp versatility is just way too fun to watch as a neutral spectator. And you guys want to face them, but they could pull off something special.
Yeah, they have a lot of odd picks, but I don't know, we are really good at handling curveballs, so we don't really care.
We also see that Heimerdinger curveball coming out, so no problem there. The third one is from @StevieGTV. I've most enjoyed watching Millennium. Despite being eighth, they brought unmatched aggression and personality to the Rift.
I mean, we have to agree. We have seen Aaron here, of course, was no longer the jungler, and Codnix coming in and doing so well. Like, when he's playing Kha'Zix, we always see aggressive plays, aggressive games from Millennium. We got Jiri pulling out the Blitzcrank. I mean, we got multiple picks from them. And also, the whole trackball thing with Curb, every single time he makes a play, you're like, how does he do it? So Millennium as a team, despite losing, actually plays some pretty cool games.
Absolutely, very fun to watch them always. As for you guys at home, thank you very much for those responses. As always, keep the conversation going by sending us your tweets with the #LCS. Now we're going to take a quick break and dig through the couch cushions to see if we can afford more Poro snacks. But keep it here, because we'll return with Alliance versus